I am on a mission to integrate Canva into everything we do. Not just me using it and a few other teachers, but everyone across the school. To save time, to put resources in the same place, and to make us work in the same way that hundreds of other companies do as well across the world. Why, just because we're a school, are we not using the top quality tech that we could? Hey, I am Poppy LeMar, also known as the teacher with pink hair. I'm a primary school teacher working specifically with reception in early years. I work in Bedford in Kings Oak Primary School, and we're a huge school of 4 classes per year group. I'm also the technology coordinator for my school. I'm going to start with AI. Canva rolled out amazing AI features in their recent Canva Create launch. The one that I love the most is Magic Write. I'm going to show you how to use AI to help you lesson plan, write reports, even write an IPP, or at least give you ideas on how to write your IPP and save you time. So I've opened up a document here, just a regular A4 document, not much different from a regular Word document you'd find using something like Microsoft. I'm going to click the Magic Write button. In here, it asks me to use about 5 or more words to describe what I want to write. I'm going to start with a lesson plan. So this week I've been doing one more and one less for children in maths in reception, a concept that's used with a base in reception in early years and into Key Stage 1. So lesson plan, one more and one less. I'm going to click generate and see what I get. So here we go. A full 45 minute lesson plan written, broken up into an introduction, modeling and practices and activities in less than a minute. Now, I know we're all going to have to put this into our school formats to meet the needs of our school policies. But essentially, I'm not staring at a blank screen wondering how to redo this again and how to word it, because I've got a starting point. So I'm going to insert that into my Canva document. And as you can see, I've even got things like resources. I can hand this now to my TA and they can resource my lesson. I can also, there we go, highlight a certain bit, because I'm finding this really formally written and my school's moved to a less formal way of planning. So I'm just going to go to the direct instruction. I'm going to highlight this, go to Magic Write, and I'm going to click More Fun. It's going to edit what is written into a less formal style. Let's get hands-on with a visual demo. Grab some objects and let's count our way through it. If this was handed to an ECT, they'd know exactly what to say because they've virtually got a script. Should we look at how to write a report a bit quicker this time? Ready for next summer? So I'm going to open a new document and I'm going to Magic Write again. I'm going to write school report, statements. I want to know that Emma has achieved a high level of understanding plants and nature in science lessons. What I also love is no matter where you are in Canva, it highlights your spelling mistakes. So for someone that is a quick typer and dyslexic, it's perfect. So we go to generate. Let's see what we get. Right. Straight away, you're going to be thinking that's way too much for a science statement for a primary school report. So let's have a look at this. I'm going to take this first section. This looks brilliant. It covers exactly what we've done in science this year and where Emma's most detailed knowledge lies in the anatomy of a plant and in ecosystems, because that's actually in our Key Stage curriculum. I'm going to go for More Fun. There we go. And you know what? I quite like an informal-ish report. Parents these days do not need to be reading an A-level style essay to know how their child's performing at school. Emma's basically the plant whisperer in our science class. She's got the lowdown on photosynthesis, plant bits and nature hangouts like nobody's business. Okay, I know my head teacher's going to hand this back to me and say, why are you using the word lowdown in a report? So let's go back to Magic Write after we've highlighted this and go with rewrite. This has worked. This is going to go straight into a report. But the most important thing about Canva and using AI within your school is, number one, it needs to save you time. And number two, it still means you need to pay attention. You can't just copy and paste it in. AI is a developing type of technology, and they're not a teacher. So I've got almost exactly what I want to write, but I am going to lose the section where it says she's becoming a true queen of the green world. We all know that's not going to go into a child's report, and your children's parents at home will probably wonder why you've added that. But essentially, I've just written a science statement that I could use in all my high ability children that understand science around plants, because I could also keep using the rewrite button to just tweak it a little bit. So you work in a school and you probably use an interactive whiteboard or a smart board. What if I told you Canva could be your whiteboard as well? I use it every single morning and then all the way through the day in my early years classroom. And some of my Key Stage 1 and 2 colleagues are starting to use it too. I've opened a blank whiteboard, and the first thing you need to check with any whiteboard software is, can you write on it or draw on it? Yeah, I can. There we go. I can erase easily. I can change pen colours and width. I can highlight. There's your basics. Now, let me show you the things that make it so much better than the software you're probably using. So this morning, I want my children to walk into the classroom and start writing about pirates, because we're doing some creative writing on pirates in English, and actually let's get their brains ready to go, quiet and down. Actually, it's related to the work they're going to do in about an hour. I'm going to go into my elements feature and I'm going to write pirate ship and see what I automatically get from my royalty free instantly on demand images. There we go. I've got photos or videos. So I work with early years, so I'm looking at these and I think they're great for Key Stage 1 and 2. There could be some really evocative descriptions, but they're not quite right for my age group. So I will go back to graphics, and there we go. Which child who is age 4 doesn't want to walk into the classroom and find a cartoon style picture of a pirate ship on the board? So there we go. There's my pirate ship. And I'm just going to move that over here. Resize it slightly. There we go. And just to prep, because it is the morning, I want them to practice writing the date. So today is Friday, the 12th of July, 2024. There we go. So I've got that back on the board as well. Now, one of the children over on that table asked how I write the word red. I know it might be a bit different for you guys. You could be looking at the word treasure, telescope, something a bit more complex. But my children are asking how to write the word red. So I'm not going over to my computer and typing and losing that engagement for my children. I've got them sound it out. I'm about to scribe it straight onto the board, ready for them to go. No different to any other smart software we have available. You're not in reception or early years, you're in Key Stage 2. I get it. So they finished doing their writing this morning and they've described this fabulous pirate ship. And you want to keep their interest ready for tomorrow's morning work or the creative writing you're doing later. So you quickly go down to the AI image generator, because you've got 5 minutes still before assembly. You ask one of the children to read out the description of the pirate ship. Should we put it in here and see what it comes up with? And wow the children, because their description's all of a sudden an AI generated image. Let's have a look. So the old oak pirate ship with ripped sails and a aged ship's wheel rocked on the stormy seas violently. Okay, should we see what happens? So remember, it's AI, so some of the images can be a bit squiff, but again, it's a developing software and you can always ask it to regenerate other images. There we go. So let's lose my reception set up and let's have a look at what it's generated. Yeah, so if I was a year 6 child, a year 5 child even, I'd be really chuffed that my description has just thrown together this AI image, because all of a sudden what I've written on paper actually means something. And if it was me as a teacher, I'd be screenshotting this, sending it over to my children's parents and say, because of their morning work that they've done in 10 minutes, the moment they've walked into school, we've generated an image like this. This is also a feature I love using across the school with descriptions and creative writing, because some children love writing, some children not so much, but when they see it come to life, they'll keep writing later, they'll keep writing tomorrow, because all they want you to do is put that into the AI generator and bring it up on the board for their friends. That's how I use it every single morning. That's how some of my colleagues in year two use whiteboard every single morning. You can literally treat it like PowerPoint. You can upload your PowerPoints to it and it will turn it into a flipbook. Thanks for joining me to look at the main features I've been using this month in my school. Canva's literally saving me time and changing the way my entire school teaches.